I don't want to cheat them out of a second of music. It's 6:30 now, okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Can I get a hell yeah? Okay, you guys are too sober, that's okay. As I'm assuming most of you know, my name is Indy Neidell. Those of you who don't know that, well, that's my name. And here's the thing. A couple years ago, during a Sabaton History episode, and it's on camera, I was talking to Per, and I was saying, yeah, you know, the next time we have the Sabaton cruise, I should play like the Great War album on piano. And he said, yeah, okay. And I wasn't serious, I wasn't kidding, it was just a throwaway, you know, line. But, you know, Per, he's like very like OCD about things. And in October, he's like, well, we're gonna have the cruise, so you're gonna play. I'm like, what? If you're gonna play the Great War album. Yeah, he's like, yeah, you still want to play it? And you know, you have to put your money where your mouth is. Like, yeah, sure, I'll play the Great War album on the Sabaton cruise, and that is what I'm going to do for the next 40 minutes or so. Now, walking around today and walking around yesterday, I'm talking to people that are fans of Sabaton History. Hey,
hello.
So, a bunch of people were saying that they had no idea that I actually play any kind of music. And I do play music, otherwise it would really suck to play the entire Great War album on piano if I did not know how to play piano.
Fuck back to America!
That's how Hannes and I always greet each other. Every time we see each other. Oh, this old thing? Now, if you're gonna play the piano, you should dress like you're gonna play the piano, right? If I was gonna play drums, I'd, you know, dress like that. I play a whole bunch of instruments, actually. And the first one I played was piano, and I started playing piano all the way when I was 4 years old, and not because I wanted to, but because my grandfather, Harry Neidell, right? He was one of the world's great violinists in the 30s and 40s. He played with like the New York Symphony, he played on Broadway musical stuff. May you what? I thought you were going to slap me.
I could, but I won't.
No. Yeah, of course. Take anything you like that's not within my reach. But Harry Neidell, okay. First of all, he also invented the name Neidell. His name was Harry Knadler, right? When he was starting to get famous in the 30s. And his friend said, man, that sounds too Jewish, man. You gotta change it. I mean, well, he was Jewish, but you know, he changed it. And he said, so first he changed it to Harry Needle, like needle and thread, right? And then all his friends said, that's just stupid. And then he changed it to Neidell. And that is where Neidell comes from. That's why there's not like a whole lot of other Neidells, because, well, somebody back in the past had to make a lot of really good dumplings. Knödel, right? Because Knödler, he was somebody in my family history made fucking good dumplings, and then Grandpa ruined that and made it less Jewish sounding. And because he was, you know, this world famous musician and practiced 8 hours a day and played all night, he insisted to my dad, the first male grandchild, learn a musical instrument as soon as he could. And I have two older sisters, but I was the first male grandchild. So when I was like 4, I had to start taking piano lessons, and that was 30 minutes a day. You know, I had to practice. And mom would set a timer, and if I didn't, you know, I don't hear any piano, just sitting there like this. And when you're like 6 years old, 30 minutes is like 5 fucking years when you're like 6 years old, right? And I hated it. I hated piano lessons. I hated it. It was all classical stuff. And then, but it wasn't until I was like 11 or so, and then at school, like people, can you play piano? And I was better than all the other kids. And then I didn't hate it so much. And then I had this really cool piano teacher named Lee Anthony. He's like, so, you don't have to play classical stuff. He actually taught like this. Like, what sort of stuff do you want to play? And I wanted to be cool. What I listened to mostly at the time was like Kiss and AC/DC and Cheap Trick when I was like 10 years old. But I wanted to be cool, and I'm like, Led Zeppelin and stuff. So he actually brought me sheet music for Stairway to Heaven. I'm like, I blanked on the song. But there's one song I should be able to name in the world. So that changed everything. But then when I was a teenager, and I started playing with bands. I'm like, well, I don't want to be the keyboard player, man. I want to be the guitarist. Guitarists are cool. Guitarists get laid more and stuff like that. I'm like 15, 16. So I taught myself guitar, and then I played guitar for years, and I played drums as well, actually.
And got laid even more.
I did get laid even more when I started playing drums. And on the next Sabaton Cruise, I'm going to do the entire Great War album on drums. And now that I've said it, now that leads me to something. That's something I've always thought. The most annoying person in the entire history of the world has to be Mr. Tambourine Man. He goes on, "Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me." Okay, here's some Jingle Bells. Ching, 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 ching. Yeah, so two Sabaton Cruises from now, I'm playing the Great War album. I'll tell you. Well, let's actually play something. Now, one thing that was very interesting about learning the songs is some of them work great on piano, and some of them work less great on piano. I got a real feel for the song stuff. I noticed that the songs, like the last three or four songs of the album, are the songs that really work best on piano, particularly like the end of the war. I was pounding away at home, and I got a knock on the door. I thought it was going to be a neighbor telling me to show up, and it was like 22-year-old kid saying, can I come in? There are going to be warts on this. Because of the World War and Sabaton history, I had to clear my schedule so I could have a couple of weeks to learn this. So from December 1st was when I started learning this. And I have probably at least as broad a vocal range as Joachim, but it's a different range. So some of the songs I had to change the key, and some of the songs I had to like sing the verse normally and sing the chorus an octave lower because it'll suck worse if I don't. Actually, I can't hear the piano very well. My sound guy. I'm just going to turn up the amp if that's okay. Could someone turn up the amplifier that's right down there? I'm sorry. Yeah, because I got tons of vocals. Okay, here we go. Thanks. A desolate wasteland.
fray, coming over trench and wire, moving the end of the tray.
You guys all have drinks, right? Tell you what, I'm a fuckload better when you're drunk.
Cool! You too!
Do you want that back or is it now mine?
It is yours.
You sure you can afford it?
No.
Oh, come on, you know. I know I'm a card that should be dealt with.
Yeah, you heard me. All right, the next song I'm going to play is about me. Yeah, next song on the album is Seven Pillars of Wisdom, and it's about me. In fact, there's a whole little film with my friends from Sabaton and me. All right? So, okay. This actually is a little more piano friendly than...
It's fucking awesome.
So, okay.
You're
fucking awesome. I don't know what you said, but I'm assuming that. If it was something else, I'm rolling with that.
You're fucking awesome in that one.
Okay, I'm fucking awesome in that one. Did I suck in the Unkillable Soldier?
I don't know, did you?
All right, here's Seven Pillars of Wisdom, a really boring book.
Yes.
Yes, okay.
Sabotage, the game is about to unfold. Warman spreads his wings as the battle begins. May the land lay claim unto Lawrence's name. Seven pillars of Mr. Meister blame. As the darkness falls, in Arabia falls. Warman spreads his wings as the battle begins. May the land lay claim unto Lawrence's name. Seven pillars of wisdom, lights the flame.
Now this one was tricky because this one, I started playing and I said, okay, the verse fits my range and stuff. And then I get to the bridge and I'm like, oh, fuck. Either I do it and then I can sing it, but then I can't sing anything high for the next 20 minutes after that while my turn. So this is more of a drop up and down kind of adventure. Adventure. Isn't it nice we're on an adventure together?
Yes.
Are you guys enjoying this so far?
Yeah!
Okay, next time I want a hell yeah.
Hell yeah! I got you, Indy.
I'm enjoying it too.
In the draft in 1917, a man from Tennessee. Overseas with the trenches, he went from the land of the free. Into war, he brought two things along, a rifle and his faith. Joined the ranks as a private, assigned to 338. And then, on the day, out in York, entered the fray, saving the day. To the fires of hell, the Argonne hero to be. Entered the war from over the sea. It's a meeting 1918, all the way from Tennessee. In 223.
Sounds weird.
You got it.
It's
when his faith had been put to the test, the call to arms he heeds. On the 8th of October he went, made a sergeant for his deeds. Fearless leading the raid of the war, machine gun on the hill. Charged the enemy, taking the prisoners by the power of his will. And then, on that day, Sergeant York entered the fray, saving the day, the 82nd all the way.
That sounds weird.
Yeah.
That sounds weird. I mean, how many times do you go to a concert and the band finishes playing a song and they go, hey, we're gonna play this bit again just because we really like this bit. I think that's fucking beautiful. I love it. That's great shit. All right. This also has a really fun middle bit on the piano. The rest of it, yeah, works okay on the piano, but the middle bit might be my favorite part of any of the song. But I need some love potion number wine right now. So, cheers, everybody!
Score!
Get this snap!
Rost alive! Make any sense because it's going to be in a different key and I'm only playing the right hand, right? That's a good start. My wife, who is there, and the thing, like, I've been walking around, you know, singing the songs all the time, and we were in the elevator the other day. She's like, just stop that. I'm like, what? She goes, you've been doing everything, you keep going higher. I'm saying that out loud. She's like, yes, you're saying it. Like, you fucking say it all the time. What is it? I'm like, oh shit. Sorry, honey. Sorry,
I'm running higher.
know, some friends of mine have a band, right? And they're playing on the boat. They're playing at 8 o'clock in the Starlight Lounge. The band called Sabaton. They're really good. I think you guys are going to hear a lot from them in the next couple of years. And I figure as long as I'm here and I've got a stage, you know, I might as well, you know, shout out for my friends. But I see a couple of people wearing a Sabaton shirt. I shouldn't really pronounce it like that always. People go, wait, it's Sabaton? Hey, no. Who does Sabaton history?
It's Swedish. Really, it's Sabaton.
I bet. I know. And I didn't even realize that till yesterday. They had, in the pub, the Sabaton drink specials, but they had two B's at first minute, so it was Sabaton, which is destroy the sound, basically. And I learned so much. That was great.
Okay. Let's also break it up.
What? Oh yeah. Hey, how am I doing on time?
20 minutes.
Okay, cool. Because I understand I want to get you guys over there to see that band. So it's okay. But I've only got a few more songs left. So.
Since I'm in a hurry, I might as well have a.
Hey.
Next song is fucking good. Yeah. Let's fight the one in the middle.
The one in the middle?
Keep on watching on and play the great score. There will be no encore.
I'm feeling quite afternoon. Like I said, when filming this, all we gotta do is get one good shot. And go, oh man, I wish I'd seen that show.
Oh no!
Do you ever go outside?
Now this is really good when I get it right, this, but it's tricky because it's a ghost in the trenches, but it's a bit of a different song.
Like I said, the second half of the album, there's a lot more piano-y things you can do. The Great War, the middle bit I usually do better, but
this octave sounds really weird. So.
Change the song.
No, something it's something with the resonance. It's not my piano.
So I'm gonna break it.
Alright, let's see. There's gonna be some errors in this, but I really, really enjoy playing this song. This is a really fun song to play on the piano, just so you know. Okay. And I had to do it an octave lower.
Because it was only written that way.
I don't need help with.
sabaton. He blew up. Neidell. Neidell plays sabaton.
Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna start this off a little, little higher, and then it'll turn into something that you recognize.
Sorry? You're magnetized by me slaughtering C sharp minor.
It's supposed to cast.
Okay, cool. Okay, then I'll do this quick. Okay, so.
The 1,000,000 shells of Scotland, the land, no one has the upper hand. But the ground in the trenches, when the soldiers make their stand. And the trenches slowly turn to mud, and they really start to flood. There are weeds in every corner, and they die in the mud for the trenches to flood. Descent into darkness. 303 days below the sun feels up a gun. Set a wasteland from the grass. Thou shalt go no further. It was said, thou shalt not pass. The spirit of resistance and the madness of the war. So go ahead, face a lead, join the dead, throw your knife, throw your life.
You're going to make that you never make at home, you make them the first time live, and then you don't make them again. You're like, okay, that's where I'm going to fuck off. So now I know that I really have to work on Ghost of the Trenches. I'm gonna let you guys out of here, so I'll get this back. So.
Change
his
out.
But I don't know
what to say,
so go. Did it get louder out there or just here? Yeah. It's way better louder, isn't it? Yeah. You want me to play the whole album again? Huh?
Yeah! Rusty,
that's
so mad!
That's way better when it's louder.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, I've got to leave you now, but I was going to do And in Flanders Fields, they do a song version of it on the album. To me, especially as a historian, on Flanders Fields, in Flanders Fields is a poem, and I was going to recite the poem in Flanders Fields, but I'm not going to do that now. I was inspired by them last night. After their show night, when everybody was walking away. Remember a few years ago, it used to be My Heart Will Go On?
Please don't do the heart
hunting. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
No, that
when
was...
I was born in 1967. So when I was 12, in like 1979, right? I loved sticks, man. And I learned Come Sail Away when I was a kid. And I can still play the whole piano part, so I'm listening to that. I don't think I'm gonna sing the Cartman version, because I'm a really good Cartman.
Cartman.
Here you guys, I'm going home. Me, him.
We have an error.
Come sail away.
Bye.
time because you will have to get hungry. And he will have to get some sabaton. So your encore is, I'll come up with an encore. Okay, next year I'll start the show with Swedish Pagans, whatever it is. How's it?
Yeah.